Holy Spirit, we will never be the same. And then before long, you will join me and start shooting your own. And now Satan is outnumbered. I'm shooting on one side. You are shooting on the other side. The Holy Ghost is shooting on one side. Jesus is shooting on one side. And the fire, hey, we have them outnumbered. Say, rejoice in the Lord, always. I said, Lord, do you mean you did not leave us any room to complain about anything? Have you ever seen anybody living like this? So this is not a message for me to do one Sunday and we move on. No, I'm going to keep camping out here. Every Sunday. Until you walk through the door. Hey, good morning. Hey! There's fire in my bones. Hey, hallelujah. Glory to God. Eh? You wake up in the morning and the glory is hovering over you. Because even while you are asleep, your spirit man is rejoicing. You've trained your spirit man to rejoice. Man, I came back from Nigeria and then I developed that malaria. You know, they don't have the right medicines over here and it's hard to find and expensive. That thing had me down for 3 weeks. But I was told that even while I was asleep, I was praying in tongues. I said, really? They said, yeah. You were talking in tongues. And then somebody else came to see me while I was asleep. They told me the same thing. He said, you're talking in tongues. But it sounded like you were sending angels on assignment. He said, that's what the tongue sounded like. You see what I'm saying? You can train your spirit that even when you are asleep, your spirit man is alive. Because in all your waking moments, you're looking at him. I don't care what the devil is doing. Lord, what are you saying? I see what the issue is, but what are you saying? No, you don't understand what I'm telling you. Every time I get a huge bill on a go on, I look to him. What are you saying? What are you saying? I don't care what the numbers are saying. I just want to know, hey, are you up with this? Hallelujah. And when he pays for it, I said, okay, that's all I needed. Hallelujah. Come on. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? You can't stop the enemy from shooting at you, but you can put out the shield of faith. And I don't know any better way to put out a shield of faith than rejoicing. I'm rejoicing that I have somebody. Okay, okay. You didn't get it. Huh? I have somebody who will fight for me, who will stand up for me. Glory to God. Say, rejoice in the Lord. Always. And again. I say, in case you didn't get it, I say, rejoice. We have to learn this. None of us have practiced this. So we're on the beginning of it. Week after week. Until everybody's rejoicing. Every time somebody pulls up an issue, you say, let's rejoice. Let's rejoice because the Lord has already solved it. He said the works were finished from the foundation of the world. The miracles were not wrought when the problems came. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You see? Glory to God. Come on. Look at the next line. That's my new friend. It's Philippians. He says, let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord. I hope you brought your shouting shoes on. He says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. He said, let your moderation, meaning this is the cure for you acting crazy. He said, let your moderation be known unto all men. That's why I said, that's your cure. Because your moderation being known to all men is that they see you handling difficult things without throwing a fit, without punching somebody, without yelling and screaming, without cursing. So everybody should be convinced, having been around you, that you're moderate. Hallelujah. Huh? He said, let your moderation be known unto all men. And this thing leaped up off that page and hit me like the stone hit Goliath in the forehead. Boom! What hit me? It's right there in front of you. He said, the Lord is at hand.
Yeah.
I said, wait a minute. What are you telling me? They're telling me rejoice. Keep rejoicing. Why are you rejoicing? He said, you know the God of your breakthrough. Do you see how close your hand is? He said, the Lord is within your hand reach. You are this close to your breakthrough. No, you're not shouting, right? I say you're this close to your miracle. Huh? He said, the Lord is at hand. He's not afar off. He's near. He's here. Hallelujah. That's how we're going to change everything. We've prayed enough. Let's joy it out. He said, with joy, you shall draw water out of the well of salvation. This stuff is in there. Pull it out. Hallelujah. Get a shout going. Huh? And he said, when you can't get a word out, get an attitude. Ooh, glory to God. Glory to God. Said, the Lord is at hand. You are that close to a breakthrough. You're that close to a miracle. You're that close to the answer you've been waiting on. You're that close. Close as your hand. As close as your reach. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. Glory to God. People around me through the years will tell you that they've heard me say this over and over again. I said, I'm not worrying about Satan. It's God I'm worried about. If God is pleased, there's nothing the devil can do. When I see these believers are hunting for demons on every rock, I say, you're pointing to the wrong direction. There's no room for devils. I barely can contain a finger of God. I don't have room for devils. I don't preach devils. I don't teach you to be looking for devils. I teach you glory. Jesus. Miracles. The helper to the helpless, the father, to the fatherless, the husband, to the widows. Hallelujah. Is our God in his holy temple? Glory to God. And if we can learn this joy thing, my God, we will reverse so many things. Demons will be running when they see us. Now, there's them rejoicing bunch. There's no solution for this. Hallelujah. I just had a flash. I remember the first time we went to Sacramento, California. Do you remember? And these people, I guess they have never seen black folks praying. When you see black folks, you think Black Lives Matter. They've come to tear up the Capitol and all of that. So they came out in force. First the ones on the bicycle, and then the ones on horses. And then it's like, I said, this is hilarious. You know, we had this much power, yeah?
Hallelujah.
So I raised altars, and then we started marching. They kept hanging around and looking for something, you know, because that's what the police does, or that's what they do. They keep looking for something that will be their open door, then to clamp down on you. And they kept, and oh, I forgot the dogs. Dogs. They came out with bicycles, dogs, horses. Watch. And we started marching. And then we went, because you can't go round, because this, you know, they have a tunnel construction or whatever going on the backside. So we, it's like a U. You come, and then you turn around. And then all of a sudden, we were coming back, and then they got the horses now blocking the whole way. And they started coming to us. And guess what I did? I said, Moshota brakete moho soba. Shinde, I said, hey, we're on a collision course now. Mogo bota hasa, krahasha tene mohosa, menge damahasa. And the leaders, they're following me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And we kept coming, and they kept coming, and we kept coming, and they kept coming, and we kept coming. And all of a sudden, they turned away. And we kept going. Watch. The Holy Spirit just gave me a flash of that thing. He said, that's exactly what we ought to be doing. When three or four get together, we link up. Hallelujah. We're all talking in tongues. We're all going the same direction. What's our direction? Joy. Hallelujah. We came together to win this thing. We came together to shut up devils. We came together to root out every evil. Hallelujah. And they're marching, we're marching. Huh? They must blink. What I'm doing out there at the capitals, that's what you must do in your neighborhood. That's what you must do every time believers get together. You link up hands, hallelujah, and start rejoicing. Demons will take flight. Listen, beloved, before I pray, no matter what you claim to believe, God will permit Satan to come and check you out. Everybody wants to make sure that you actually believe what you say you believe. I had an experience yesterday. Yesterday was Saturday, isn't it? Our meeting, leadership meeting, took an interesting turn. And I shared so many things I hadn't shared before with my leaders. And then there were some doctrinal issues. And I had to clarify my position on those things. And then when we finished, and I laid down to pray, I went to pray, but God didn't let me get a word in. As soon as I laid down, he started screaming at me. I am the Lord that brought you through cancer. I am the Lord that brought you through COVID. I am the Lord. He started thundering his credentials. Woo! I jumped up. I said, what am I praying? I'm done. I started praising God. I started shouting. I started lifting up my voice. In other words, it don't matter what problems I just heard you talking about, but I want you to know I am bigger than your problems. I am bigger than this. I am God that brought you through cancer, that brought you through COVID, that brought you through all the attacks of the enemy. So when I'm preaching, God heals. I'm not preaching a theory. I said, God heals. God delivers. Ooh, hallelujah. I am the testimony. Before it's over with, you're gonna be shouting every day. You're gonna be praising God. You're gonna be rejoicing. You're gonna join the elite believers on the earth. Sons of God. But we celebrate the bread and the wine. It's a testimony that Jesus has prevailed. It's a testimony that we have every right to rejoice. It's a testimony that the glory is here, the miracles are here, and signs and wonders follow. Bless this bread and wine. Use it to quicken and to heal and to deliver. Manifest yourself. And we'll be careful to give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. The bread and wine you have in your hand is a point of contact. I didn't blow on it, I didn't touch it, but I'm speaking to it. I said the bread you have and the wine you have is your point of contact. Jesus, I decree, will manifest himself. The moment you receive it, claim your miracle. Claim your breakthrough. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Watch. I said, claim your miracle. Claim your breakthrough. And as I was turning, I just had a flash. And I could see it's like a roadway and the enemy has put a block, but that block is like leaning this way. All right? It's like leaning this way. It's a road. And then this thing is blocking like this. But on this side, I saw light. Hallelujah. All we need now is your faith. That light there is an angel that will move that barricade off your path. Hallelujah. Receive it. Believe it. And it will manifest in Jesus' name. The Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Let it go into your system now and heal you and open doors for you and cause the darkness over your heart to flee so you can see and receive. In Jesus' name, receive it now." After the same manner also he took the cup and he said, "This is the New Testament, the new covenant in my blood. Drink it now to seal this covenant and to seal this promise and to seal your breakthrough in Jesus' name. Drink." Amen. I receive it. Open doors. Open doors. Barricades removed. Hindrances off my way. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The miracles are moving here. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is defying the enemy. Mercy is rejoicing against judgment. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Look at that. Look at that. Glory to God.
Beloved, we celebrate the demonstrations of the Holy Spirit in our services. The glory is what sin took from us, and the glory is what the Lord Jesus brought back by the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the mystery of this new covenant is in the blood. Did you see me toss my communion cup way across the way to someone, and the power of God hit them and they fell down? That is demonstrations of the glory. I remember years ago when God was using Benny Hinn across America with those crusades, and he would throw his jacket and people would fall out and all of that. And then these well-meaning brethren told him that that was sensationalism and talked him out of doing those things. And then Benny listened to them. And I've watched all those things seem to have faded away. I said, if I were in that position, before I would listen to you, I'll ask you to throw your jacket. Let's see if something will happen. Otherwise, you cannot counsel from beneath the realm that you haven't experienced. How do you know that God, who is honoring the throwing of the jacket, didn't want the jacket thrown? If God doesn't honor it, it wouldn't happen. I said, I wouldn't listen to such counsel. I was in service, and God said, "Now throw up your communion cup." And I threw it up, and all my leaders hit the ground. You can't counsel me out of that. It's the same challenge we have in Christendom. We are always trying to package the glory to fit humanism, man's perspective, what should be and what should not be. What is wrong with sensationalism? I mean, how sensational was it for Jesus to take 5 loaves and 2 fishes and feed 5,000 men? and they pick up 12 baskets full of fragments. That is sensational. And he made clay and put on the man's eyes, and bang. That's sensational. Glory to God. What are we talking about in this generation? If God gives me a chance, or when God gives me a chance, I'm not listening to any of this stuff, because he told me that in these last days, he wouldn't be preaching. It would be glory demonstrations to silence all false religions who cannot contradict God, and they're deceiving the people. And we must show them the glory of God. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And now the Lord Jesus has redeemed us and brought the glory back. And we need to demonstrate the glory. Hallelujah. The apostles, early apostles, raised the dead. They healed the cripple. They cast out the devil out of the woman, fortune telling and all of that. It caused them to be thrown in jail in Philippi, but it changed the whole city. Yeah? There's so many miraculous things in the New Testament that we must pay attention to. Is your life full of glory? Have you experienced the glory? Is the glory moving in your church? How can the glory move when we get God in a time schedule? It's an hour, 1.5, and we aggrandize ourselves, how the service is quick, and we get it out of the way, and we can get on with our day. But what has happened to you? If somebody bites into you, do they get Jesus or do they get devils? These are the questions you ought to answer in 2024, because God is saying that we must grow spiritually, exponentially, 2024. He's ready to bless us and father us into a blessing we have not known. So join us in the quest for more glory. A new level, a new season, a new level of glory, a new level of manifestation, a new level of miracles, a new level of signs and wonders. That the discouraged will have hope. The defeated will be raised up. Huh? The oppressed will be made free. Hallelujah. The bound will be loosed. And above all, the poor will have the gospel preached to them. You can live in victory through Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you, beloved. Come to Bible study tonight, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. It's a new year. Make different decisions. Do things differently. You will see God move differently. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye.